What's going on, everybody? It's Bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to explain lists in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you wouldn't mind, please like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get down to business. I got to explain lists to you all. Now, a list is used to store multiple items within a single variable. For example, let's say we have a variable called food, and I will store a string value of pizza because I like pizza. What we could do is that we can store multiple items within this variable by turning this variable into a list. And in order to do so, we're going to surround all of the values that we would like to add to our list with a set of square brackets. And boom, there you have it. We now have a list called food. It is no longer a variable. So what we could do is add multiple items to this list of food. So let's add some other food items that we might like. Let's see, I also like maybe some hamburgers and a hot dog. And maybe some spaghetti. I think I spelled spaghetti right. Okay, so we now have a list called food. Now what happens if we attempt to print this list of food? So print food. So this will print all of the elements found in this list. Each item in a list is referred to as an element. If we need to access a certain element of this list, we have to list the index. So next to our list, we'll add a set of square brackets again, and we need to list the numbered index of the element that we're trying to access. Now computers, they always start with zero, so the first element in our list would be element number zero, the next one would be one, two, and three. So if we need to access element zero, which is in the first position, we would say food, square brackets, and then within here, list the index. So the first position is zero, and this will now print the first element of our list, which is pizza. Let's attempt to access some of these other elements. So the element at index one would be, you guessed it, hamburger. Two would be hot dog, and three would be spaghetti. Now what happens if we attempt to access the element at index four? Well, currently that's out of range because we did not assign a value. So we're experiencing an error, an index out of range error. But if I were to add another element, let's say pudding. All right, well then the element at index four would be pudding then. One important concept with lists is that you can always update and change the elements found within a list later on in the program after you declare one. So let's say we would like to immediately change one of these elements. Let's say food. At index zero, I want to replace with maybe sushi because sushi is great. So if I were to print the element at index zero, this would no longer be pizza because we updated element zero to be sushi then, and this prints sushi. Now, if you need to display all of the elements found within a list, you can easily do so with a standard for loop. What we'll do is say for x in the name of our list, which is food, print x. And let me turn this line into a comment. All right, so this for loop will print all of the elements found within our list of food. And the results are sushi, hamburger, hot dog, spaghetti, and pudding. All right, people, for this next portion, I'm going to demonstrate a few useful functions of lists. And to access some of these functions, type the name of your list, dot, and there's a bunch to choose from here. Let's begin with append. We can add an element to this list. Let's say at the end, I would like to add ice cream. So then if I were to display my list, we now have ice cream at the end because we appended this value to my list of food. So let's go over a few others. So we can also remove a value, food.remove. Let's say I would like to remove hot dog. So I'm going to type that within my function, and this will remove hot dog, and that is no longer here. Next, we can pop, food.pop. Pop will remove the last element, so this will remove pudding. We can insert a value at a given index, food.insert, we need to list an index, let's say 0, that would be the first position, technically, that's where pizza is currently, and I would like to add cake. And at index 0, we now have cake. So next up, we have sort. Food.sort. This will sort a list alphabetically. So in the first position, we have hamburger, hot dog, pudding, spaghetti, then sushi. We can also clear a list. Food.clear. And this will remove all of the elements of a list. So this will not print anything because we cleared the list. Well, everyone, in conclusion, a list is really just a variable that can store multiple values. Think of it that way. So if you would like a copy of all the code that we have written here today, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how lists work in Python. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.